All praise be to Allah and peace be upon Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Eid will soon begin. Takbir, prayers, slaughter of cows, camels and sheep to feed the poor, needy relatives and family will be everywhere in Muslim households as people celebrate and praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
You've said a lot of cool things, but one thing always makes me sad.
Weird. In Eid, you feel sad about something? What is it?
It's not weird. I have compassion and mercy for animals. And the Islamic way is cruel to them. What are you thinking when you kill these poor animals without mercy? No living thing should be killed. We should only consume plant-based food.
It's so funny. Plants and trees are also alive, and they die when you cut them and eat vegetables. So it's not a good idea to kill plants, or insects, or bacteria, or cut down trees to make homes and furniture. Bro, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made everything He created with a purpose in this life, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows the best.
I agree. It's not the same though. Knives are used to kill animals without mercy. At least you can tranquilize these animals in a chemical method, which is how most developed countries care for their animals. By shocking, sedating, or suffocating them. That makes sense, right? Isn't it painful to slaughter animals in the Islamic method? Since Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is compassionate and merciful, why would He expect or accept such a thing?
Why would He accept such a thing? Please allow me to answer your question step by step. In the first place, did you know that blood is the ideal environment for bacteria and germs to grow up? By shocking, gassing, or sedating them, blood will not leave the body. Rigor mortis begins to settle in, affecting all muscles and joints, the parts we will eat, and bacteria and germs will grow even after cooking. We cannot get rid of them because the fire will not reach every part of the meat. So here we face the risk of falling ill with any kind of disease. Thus, the best way to remove harmful blood from the meat is to slaughter it in the Islamic manner. By doing so, the meat will be clean, healthy, and free from any disease. So people who eat non-halal meat that is murdered in their way eat dead animals, since the animals are diseased before they are slaughtered. Isn't the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He wants us healthy and happy?
You are right, but someone told me we should cut this whole head at once to prevent torturing them.
It's known that if you chop off the whole head, they will suffer. So the best way with no pain is to follow the Islamic method, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala legislated for Adam, Ibrahim, Isa, Muhammad, and all his prophets. May peace be with them all. Also, you should keep in mind the pain animals feel doesn't last longer than 3 seconds. Because in the Islamic tradition, we don't cut the whole head, but only the jugular veins, esophagus, and trachea. Large amount of blood will be split, unlike the non-Islamic practice of slaughtering animals, which causes the meat to be full of blood and diseases. Additionally, cutting the jugular veins, esophagus, and trachea without cutting the neck vertebrae, then the nervous will take a command from the brain to bring blood for it. Because of the lack of blood after slaughtering, afterward all the blood will flow to the heart, and then the heart will pump as much blood as it can to the brain, but it will all leave because the animal was slaughtered. Moreover, this operation causes a significant amount of blood to leave the body with little pain, since the body parts were busy during the operation. By contrast, non-halal methods or cutting the whole head stop all blood flow to the brain, so the animal suffers severe pain and there is a lot of blood left in the body afterward, as the heart doesn't pump it up. Thus, the meat becomes rotten, diseased, and dark. It is a cruel and harmful to both animals and people.
Subhanallah, there is no one more merciful than Allah. However, why should we say Allahu Akbar when we slaughter?
The word Allahu Akbar reminds us of Allah's greatness as He created animals and commanded us to slaughter them as a gift and blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we could eat and feed others. With this great word, animals will be at peace and our food will be healthy, as well as many unknown secrets hidden behind this great word. Here is a video showing what animals do when hearing Allah's name.
This is all submission. This is all submission.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Walillahi alhamd. Allahu Akbar, Allah is the greatest. And finally, we are commanded by our faith to follow guidelines for the safety and welfare of the animals. For example, we shouldn't show the knives to the animals or slaughter them in front of each other. And we should sharpen our knives, relax our animals, and say Allah's name. If one doesn't follow the above rules, Islam is innocent of their evil deeds. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will question them on the day of judgment. And as for the breeding of the animals, it must be in the best manners and kindness to ensure the animal is looked after properly. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't show mercy to those who don't show mercy to others. And when people are merciful, Allah the most merciful will be merciful to them. Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, said, verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prescribed ihsan, perfection in all things. So if you kill, then kill well. And if you slaughter, then slaughter well. Let each one of you sharpen his blade and let him spare suffering to the animal he slaughters. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our good deeds and sacrifice. May we all be forgiven. Best wishes and Eid Mubarak. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.